students, how are you? I hope you all are doing well. Welcome to the SST class of second standard. Students, today I am going to start new lesson. Lesson 18, Good Habits. In this lesson, I am going to discuss meaning of habit, what are good habits and advantages of following good habits. What are bad habits and its disadvantages? What is the meaning and use of magic words? So the objective of the topic is to teach you the value of good habits. First of all, I am going to discuss meaning of habit. Habit means a regular act. Now, I am going to discuss good habits that we should follow. Number 1. Wish your elders. Students, always wish your elders whenever you meet them. They will be very happy if you help them, wish them and hug them. Wishing your elders leave good impression about you on them. Number 2. Wish your teachers. Students, whenever you meet your teachers, wish them properly. This will show respect for your teachers and the etiquettes you have. Throw rubbish in a dustbin. Always throw rubbish in a dustbin, whether you are at home, at school, or at any place. This habit will make your surrounding clean. Throwing garbage in the open will spread germs and you may fall ill. Next is, use a handkerchief while sneezing or coughing. Always use a handkerchief when you sneeze or cough. If you will not use handkerchief or cover your mouth while sneezing or coughing, it will spread germs in the air and makes your environment dirty. So use a handkerchief or cover your mouth while sneezing or coughing. You have to follow this habit everywhere. Speak politely. Always speak politely with your parents, with your grandparents. You should be polite with everyone. Talking politely with everyone leaves your good impression. When you are polite with everyone, others will listen to you more carefully. Always speak the truth. Students, never tell a lie. Always speak the truth. Telling a lie is a bad habit, so you should speak the truth. Now, before reading, I would like to discuss important terms of lesson 18, good habits. Number 1. Habit or regular act. Number 2. Good habits. Doing things in the proper way. Now students, it's a reading time. So open your book at page 88, lesson 18, good habits. What is the meaning of good habits? Doing things in the proper way. Now let's start reading. Ramesh had gone with his father and grandfather to the station to receive his uncle Sudesh, who was coming from Ludhiana. The train was late and they were waiting patiently for it to arrive. Underline waiting, write down the meaning standby. Underline patiently, write down the meaning calmly. Underline arrive, write down the meaning come. In this lesson, Ramesh had gone to the station with his father and grandfather to receive his uncle Sudesh, who was coming from Ludhiana. The train was late, so they were waiting at the station. The place was crowded with people. Underline crowded, write down the meaning overfill. Ramesh saw that many people were sitting on the platform and blocking the way. Underline blocking, write down the meaning choking. Students, as we all know, railway station is a crowded place. We see many people there. They were talking loudly and eating and throwing the wrappers on the platform. Many children were also dirtying the platform. Students, Ramesh saw many children were throwing wrappers on the platform. Now I am going to show you the picture of this bad habit. Throwing wrappers in the open is a bad habit. It will spread germs in the air and makes our surrounding dirty. So we should throw wrappers in a dustbin only. There were many people who were constantly spitting on the ground. Underline constantly, write down the meaning all the time. Ramesh found it very dirty. He asked his father, "Daddy, why are these people spitting here? It is so dirty." "Ma'am says that one should not spit in a public place. We should use the washroom." Ramesh also saw some people were spitting on the ground. Now see the picture of this bad habit. Spitting on ground, on roads or at public places is a bad habit. It will spread germs and makes our surrounding very dirty. For spitting, we should use only washroom. Daddy, these are bad habits. Underline bad, write down the meaning poor. Underline habits, write down the meaning or regular act. People have many bad habits, such as speaking or talking loudly at public places. Now it's a time to read fact. In Italy, people say ciao ciao to bid others goodbye. Now see the picture. People say ciao ciao to bid others goodbye in Italy. Now page 89. There are many people who sneeze or cough without using a handkerchief. Now students, see the picture of this bad habit. If you sneeze or cough without covering your mouth, the germs will spread in the air and it makes your environment dirty. And then you will breathe only in dirty air that may fall you sick. So use a handkerchief while sneezing or coughing. Many people use bad language while talking to others. Student, if you speak bad language or speak rudely with others, nobody will like you. You should speak politely, calmly and softly with others. That leaves good impression about you. All these are bad habits and we must always avoid such habits. So students, spitting on roads, throwing wrappers in the open, not using handkerchief while sneezing or coughing, talk rudely with others are bad habits. We must always avoid such bad habits and follow good habits only, so that everyone loves us, likes us and helps us. Now it's a time to read your wisdom. How would you wish your class teacher early in the morning? Students, when you meet your teachers, you should stand up and wish your teachers politely and respectfully, so that you will be in the good books of your teacher. So students, today I have read page 88 and discussed good habits with you. So your homework is to watch this video again and do exercise B of quiz zone on page 91. Thank you.